Hello everybody, my name is Anmol Birring. Today is April the 3rd, 2024 and today's lecture will be continuation of the lecture from last week, which is the topic is ultrasonic testing of welds. We discussed last time about ultrasonic scattering in stainless steel, and unlike carbon steel, here we have two types of scattering. In the parent metal we'll have Rayleigh scattering, and the Rayleigh scattering happens when the wavelength is significantly larger than the grain size. Then once the waves enter the stainless steel weld, we have what's called multiple scattering, and the reason is the grain structure of the stainless steel is such that it causes much more scattering to the shear waves as compared to the longitudinal waves. So the penetration of the shear waves in the stainless steel weld is really limited, and the only way you can inspect the stainless steel weld metal, or the best way to inspect the stainless steel weld metal, would be with the longitudinal waves. So here here I have the wave boards to use for the inspection of the stainless steel weld. For the parent metal, for example, the parent metal, if you are looking for crack here, then this can be inspected with L wave as well as shear waves, because both the L waves and the shear waves penetrate into the parent metal, the stainless steel pipe. But in the weld metal, the wave which actually penetrates is the L wave, because the shear wave scatters and it also skews in the weld. So here for the weld metal, which is here, the wave mode would be the longitudinal wave for inspection. So basically, to inspect the stainless steel weld, you have to use the L wave, and it can be supplemented with the shear waves for the pipe material or the parent metal. Now understand that the shear wave will produce a better reflection from a crack in the parent metal as compared to the L wave, and I will discuss that at the end of this lecture why. So here we have the wave modes. We use parent metal, L wave and shear wave. For the weld metal, L wave. So really overall you have to use L waves for sure, and can be supplemented with the shear waves. Now since we are using L wave probe, angle beam L wave probe, there is a little slight difference between using the shear wave angle beam probe and the L wave angle beam probe. The L wave single element L wave probe will be really big because of the lower incident angle, and due to that reason it actually produces a dead zone. There is a lot of noise in the wedge and it produces a dead zone on the contact surface of the part of the pipe. So in order to avoid that issue, we really have to use a dual element L wave probe, and the dual element L wave probe also has a low profile, so means that it's going to be thinner than a single element L wave probe. And making it thinner has a second advantage, is that it will have less sound loss in the wedge as compared to a single element L wave angle beam probe. So that's a probe to use, has to be a dual element. Now the third point, which is to use what type of calibration reflector to use. Normally, you know, we can use either the holes, sidered holes, or we can use the notch, the 10% notch. Now for shear waves, it doesn't make that much of a difference in sensitivity whether we use the notch or the sidered hole, and that's why the cords will actually allow you to use either the hole or the notch. However, there is a significant difference for the refracted L waves to use the notch or the sidered hole. And what you will find out is that the reflection from the notch as compared to the hole will be significantly lower. So what that means is that If you use side drill holes to create your reference level, then the sensitivity on the ID surface will be significantly lowered. So, and that happens because of the mode conversion of sound waves from the notch. So, if suppose the notch is like this here, and I'm using L waves, the sound will go here. This is the L wave, and then it's going to reflect here. And when it reflects here, it will actually mode convert to a shear wave. So we are losing the sound at this reflection boundary, and then it reflects again here as L wave, but then it also mode converts to shear wave. So as you can see that the sound is reflecting and mode converting. So the reflection from the notch will be significantly lower than the reflection from the sidewall hole. So to get the right ID sensitivity for the stainless steel inspection, you should use the ID notch as the reference level. So make sure that this is accounted in your procedure as far as the use of the notch or the sidewall hole is concerned for the inspection of the stainless steel welds, because it is not the same. So in conclusion, I covered the wave modes, the use of the dual element L wave probe, and then as far as the calibration reflector, I just kind of pointed you the difference between the hole and the notch, and saying that the reflection from the notch will be significantly lower than the reflection from the calibration side drill holes. And thank you so much.